Item 26, rezoning request, District 2.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, if I could, let me at least kick this off, and I'm just gonna make the presentation once as far as my end of it, because I don't think I need to say it again for both A and B, because I can get to where I need to be by just doing this once, and then I'll turn it over to Tom, and he can address the merits, if you will, of the zoning. This was a matter that was on your last Thursday's regular meeting, and I will say at the outset that the application, there was a certificate of completeness issued for the zoning application, which is basically planning's statement that the application in all respects appears complete. Nonetheless, the county received some concerns that there may have been some problems with the application, and I spoke with the applicant kind enough to let us have an extension so I could look at it. I wish I could tell you that I could answer everything that ever comes up on the fly, but I can't. And so I needed a little bit of time to look at that, and I have looked at it. The issue was, in the application, there is a statement within the application providing that, at least in my reading of it, anticipates that the owner is basically stating that the attorneys identified or the agents have the requisite authority to act on behalf of and speak on behalf of the principals or the property owners. In this particular situation, that statement had been executed by the attorney. So the question was, did it meet all of the requisite requirements, and was it consistent with the code, our UDC? I've looked at it. My position is the better answer is, in the context and within which that document is framed and the way it's structured, that it did need to be signed by the owner. And I will tell you that it ordinarily is signed by the owner, the actual owner, as sort of an affidavit affirming representation capacity. I've discussed it with the attorney, Mr. Underwood. We've had a spirited debate about it, and I will tell you that, and I will say this for the record, he disagrees. It may surprise you, but from time to time, attorneys disagree. And he does, and he has articulately voiced his concerns. Nonetheless, in the interest of moving forward, in the interest of addressing this issue, he has been good enough to provide affidavits of the principal with the entity affirming that all the representations in the both applications that are in front of you tonight, ZA3607 and ZA3608, affidavits from the owner affirming to the representative capacity and the authority of the attorney, and also affirming and ratifying all the representations made in the application in front of the board. The originals have been turned in to Mr. Brown. Given that what I would consider to be a curative act, I am comfortable proceeding forward. Whatever the law may be, it is absolutely the law that a principal can ratify the activities of their agent, and that, in my opinion, has occurred here with respect to both ZA3607 and ZA3608. So at this point, I feel like the application has satisfied the spirit and intent of the rule. That's all. If you have any questions, please ask me.
What about on an ongoing basis?
You know, we looked at about 50 of these. We've got on e-status and looked at about 50 applications, and we didn't find anywhere anybody, but at least from our reading, the owner was signing them. So I think this was an aberration. It may have been based upon just time demands or limitations or what have you, but this is not a customary thing, and I think we've done our best to work together and provide hopefully a timely solution.
Mr. Brown, anything else to add?
Public hearing has been completed on both these applications, and they are ready to be acted on.
You can act on them here.
You may. You can act on them here on a time-sensitive basis if you need to.
Mr. Tan, it's your district. What's your favor?
Before you, this is on the Walton Bluegrass, we gave them a whole lot in this commitment. So I don't know what all this is about, why they want to. CBD, but they could quite frankly eliminate some of the apartments in order not to have all these variances.
I don't think there would have been any apartments.
They aren't. They just white.
That's what I'm saying. They're not. And they could. So they would need to be get rid of all the buffers and shrink them down.
Should be more comfortable hearing it at the next open meeting?
Tad is not crazy about it.
that with the commercial property, Ethan, the buffer?
I'm happy to answer that. The buffers we're requesting variances to are solely against their own property. And in fact, it's against a right-of-way. So we're trying to eliminate it so that you can actually see the commercial. Now, as far as what you were asking.
But it would be between the residential and the commercial, still the buffer. You want that to go away, even though it's their own thing, still between commercial and residential, correct?
I believe that's correct.
Yes, the driveway.
It's just the driveway.
It's just the entrance.
But as you asked what was given, the commercial is staying the same size, but our clients are giving the county a lighted, video-secured, maintained parking lot for folks to access the Big Creek Greenway, which you don't have now. We're locating the commercial area from the western part, further to the east, so you actually can access it. So that's the trade-off. It certainly helps our client to have.
You're giving them public access outside of the residence for the commercial use there?
People can park there. It benefits our client because obviously they have stores they want people to frequent. At the same time, it's where people can park and access the Greenway.
So the square footage of the commercial piece stays the same?
Correct.
And the units of the
number of units stays the same.
The residential piece stays the same?
And in fact, we submitted a zoning condition that says that density is to be calculated using a small piece of Res 6 plus the existing Res 6.
So none of these conditions have changed since Thursday night?
No, sir.
No, I realize that.
I just want to clarify that. Yes, no?
Okay. And nothing on the outskirts are looking for any changes just between your CBD and the higher-end apartments, and you're saying there's a road there anyways.
So everything.
This is my client. This is David Knight.
And I want to make sure everything you and I negotiated was stays.
Okay.
Main Street, everything we talked about is the same. It's just we're just rearranging the commercial property to have a better configuration
between your own property. Then.
Yes.
We got a
this used to be in District 3 now.
Yes. All right. I'm good. If you want.
Yeah. Sure. Chairman, I would move that we approve the application by Walton Bluegrass LLC, CBD and Res 6 to CBD with a variance to eliminate the 40-foot side yard buffer and replace with a 10-foot landscape strip and with the conditions that are presented today in our book. This is ZA 3607. Yeah, time sensitive.
I'll second that.
Time sensitive?
Yes.
We have a motion and a second. Time sensitive item for Walton Bluegrass, zoning application 3607. Any more discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All in favor, item B.
Yeah. Mr. Chairman, with respect to Walton Bluegrass LLC, ZA 3608, CBD to Res 6, with a variance to eliminate the 20-foot exterior buffer, I would move that we approve that application. That's a 20-foot exterior buffer. I would move that we approve that application and with the conditions that are displayed here at that.
Time sensitive. One more. 25-foot exterior buffer. You said 20.
I said 20.
I said 20 twice?
Yeah.
Well, that's 40.
Just want to make sure we get it right.
25-foot exterior buffer.
I'm going to do a second button for discussion. This is not the same buffer reduction, is it? The variance, as you just discussed?
This is the Res 6. We have to have an exterior buffer, and we're asking to eliminate it along the commercial.
Okay, so it all goes together, what we just discussed?
Correct.
Okay. Any more questions? We have a motion and a second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Carries 5-0. Item 27.
Good afternoon.
How are you? I'm sure
I can get started if you would like.